This video is based on the teaching learning based optimization algorithm. In this video, we will try to understand what is this algorithm all about, how it is working, certain steps used in this algorithm, mathematical models used in this algorithm, and in the end, we will try to understand this algorithm with the numerical example. As you can see here, teaching learning based optimization algorithm is introduced in 2012. It is a population-based meta-heuristic optimization algorithm. And you can see here the main inspiration behind this algorithm is the behavior in the classroom. This algorithm is based on the effect of teacher on the learners in the class. And it is basically inspired by the behavior of learners in the classroom. So here we have the two main procedures in this algorithm: teacher phase and the learner phase. In the teacher phase, we have teacher, and in the learner phase, we have collection of students, or you can say learners. Now, as this algorithm is inspired by the teaching learning procedure in the real life, so first we will try to understand the teaching learning procedure so that we can easily understand how this algorithm is working. This algorithm is based on the teaching learning procedure. Here we have the teacher phase and the learner phase. In the teacher phase, learners learn from the teacher, and here we will note the effect of a teacher on the students. In the learner phase, we have collection of students, or you can say learners, and as in the real life, we can discuss the topic with the fellow friends, or even we can discuss with another students. So like that, in this algorithm, in the learner phase, learners can interact with each other, or even they can move randomly. So as in the real life, we can randomly select the person having more knowledge in order to enhance our. So like that, in this algorithm, learners can also interact with each other, and even they can interact randomly. Teaching learning based optimization algorithm, we have teacher, learners, and subjects. Learners means the collection of students. That is the current population we will assume for this algorithm. And subjects means the design variables for any optimization problem. We will consider the subjects, as certain subjects are offered to the learners. So in this algorithm, we will consider the design variables as subjects. And then you can see here we have learner, subjects. Now, as in the real life, teacher is different and learners are different, and teacher is considered as the highly learned person who train other learners to enhance their knowledge and to improve their results. So in this algorithm, we will consider the best learner among all as the teacher. And how we will select that, which one is the best? So here we will use the best value, that is the fitness value we will calculate for the learners, and best among all is considered as the teacher. Now you can see we have teacher, learner, subject, and now we have the mean result. So in this algorithm, we have the mean result. For example, just imagine here we have in a university in the computer science department, we have 30 students, and we have teacher for the data structure and the compiler design. And after teaching learning procedure, we have examination, and in examination, we have 25 students out of 30 passed in data structure, and 27 students out of 30 pass in the compiler design. So here we obtain the 83% result for the data structure and 90% result for the compiler design. So here you can see we can check the teacher effect on the learners by all this. So same in this algorithm, we will calculate the mean result. Now we have the certain steps followed in this algorithm. First, we have the initialization phase. Here we will initialize the population, maximum number of iteration. The simplicity of this algorithm is we have no controlling parameters. We have just the population size, maximum number of iteration. So this is the advantage, we have no controlling parameters. But at the same time, it is also the disadvantage. As you can see here, we have no controlling parameters. And as we have no controlling parameters, this algorithm is really stuck into the local optimum. And as this algorithm get easily trapped into the local optimum. So while solving the difficult problems, it is unable to reach the best global solution. So this is also the disadvantage. Now we have the population size in the max number of iteration, how many times you want to repeat that loop, and then we will initialize the population randomly for the individuals. Suppose we have 10 individuals, so value for I is 1 to 10, and in this algorithm we have the collection of students or learner as the current population, and best among all is considered as the teacher. And here you can see, using this we can initialize the population randomly. You can see the lower bound and the upper bound. Step 2, we will evaluate the performance for the current population. Here we will use a fitness function, or you can say objective function or cost function. So using the fitness function, we will calculate the fitness value for the each individual, and after that we will select the best solution among all. And you know, the best solution among all is the teacher. That value we will use here in the teacher phase. And after that, we will calculate the mean result. And then we will enter into the teacher phase. Here in the teacher phase, we will calculate new solution. And here you can see this is the older position. And then we have any normally distributed random value. And then you can see the best solution means the teacher that we will select in the step 3. After that, we have teaching factor that is either 1 or 2. This is randomly selected. And then we have the mean value that we will compute in the step 4. After that, we will evaluate the new solution. And then we will compare the new solution with the older one and update. And after that, we have the learner phase in the step 8. Here you can see, using this mathematical equation, we can update the new solutions again, as learners can interact with each other and even they can move randomly. So here we have the random value and the older value. So for the new solution, in this case we will check the fitness values that we will compute for the individuals, and we will compare their fitness values, and then we will generate the new solution in the learner phase. After that, we will update the current best, and then we will check the stopping criteria, and then we will display the best solution among all. Now as you can see here, we have the best solution, or you can say the teacher is fourth individual. Now let's try to understand this algorithm step by step with the numerical example. So first we have the initialization phase. Suppose we have 5 learners, or you can say students, in the current population. So value for I is here we have 1 to 5. Here x is used to denote the position for the individual. So you can see the position for the each individual in the search space here, this one. And after that, we are using here a sphere function to calculate the fitness value for each individual. So using this fitness function, we will evaluate their performance, put a value here 1 by 1, and we obtain the fitness value for the each individual. After that, in the step 3, we will select the best solution among all. And as we know, the best solution among all is the teacher. So we will compare the values here, and after, you can see the best value among all is here, fourth one. So this is the best solution, that is the teacher value that we will use in the teacher phase. After that, you can see here, as you can see here, best learner among all is the teacher. We will calculate the mean result. So in order to calculate the mean result, first we will assume the mean value as 0. And then we will add the mean value in the learner's position. So for the first learner, you can see the mean is 0 plus first learner position, and we got the value for mean is here, this one. After that, for second learner, mean value is now this one here. In this value, we will add the second learner position, and we got this. Now for the third learner, as you can see here, we have a slight error. Instead of third learner position here, the value for the fourth learner position is added. So you can see here, in the end we will obtain the mean value. So you can correct this error, just add the learner's position in the mean value, and in the end you will obtain the mean result. After that, we have the teacher phase. In the teacher phase, we are going to generate now new solution, or you can say the new position for the learners in the search space. So using this mathematical model, we can generate the new solution. Here we will add the, here we have the older position, this one, random value that is randomly selected. And after that, we have a best solution that is teacher, individual 4. And then we have teaching factor. It is either 1 or 2. And then the mean that we computed here. You will correct this. And for this example right now, I will use the mean value, this one. So here we have the mean, this one. And after that, for first individual, now we're going to generate the new position for the first individual. So just the value for teaching factor we required here. It is randomly selected either 1 or 2. So for example, here we have 1. And the mean that you will compute here, hope you will compute the correct value. Now I'm using this one. And the older value for the first learner is this one. And then best solution means the teacher. Here teacher value is this one. You can see here. Now add the values here in the older position means this one plus random value. Here we have teacher value minus 1 and mean value this one. So like that, one by one, we will add the values here for all the learners. And after that, we obtained here, you can see this one, new solution we obtained here for the 5 individuals. Now you can see we have the initial position and the cost we computed before, and now we have the new solution. Now we will compare the new solution with the older one, and then we will move to the next step. So right now we will compare the cost, that is the fitness values of new individuals, with the older one. The cost values, you can see here for the first agent, the new value that we obtained is better than the older one, so we will consider this one. For the second individual, you can see here again the new value is better as compared to this one. We will consider the minimum value as the best value. And now we have third individual. For this, you can see again new value is better than the older one. And for the fourth learner, you can see the older value is better as compared to new value, so we will consider this one. And again for the fifth learner, the older value is better than the new, so update the solution here. Now this is the new solution. We have the new position and the new cost function, and among all, best is the fourth individual again. Now we have the learner phase. In the learner phase, they can move. In the learner phase, you know, they can interact with each other and they can move randomly. So here we have the random values are selected for the individuals. And suppose for the, now suppose we are going to update the solution for the first learner. So here for the first learner, the randomly selected person, here we have second one. And the value for second learner position, you can see here this one, 2.5518, and the first learner position is this one. Now we will compare their cost or the fitness value, and we will check whether the randomly selected value is better or the older one. Now we will check whether the randomly selected solution is better than older one or not. Right now you can see the random value here, we have this one, 6.5119, and older value is 2.9533. Right now you can see condition is false, so we will move to this one. Now add the values here, older value, any random value, and then we have the older solution value, that is this one, and then the random value, and we obtained the new solution, that is this one. And then new cost is computed using the sphere function. In the fitness function, we will add the value here, and we got the new cost, this one. So like that, we will do for all the learners. For the second one, you can see here. For the third one, you can see the condition is true, so we will move to this one. as you can see here, they can interact with each other and they can either move randomly. So after that, you can see here we have the new solution again that we computed in the learner phase, and you can see the older solution that we computed in the teacher phase. Now we will compare the cost. Now we will compare the fitness values of all the solution with the new solution. And here you can see for the first learner, the new value obtained is better as compared to older one. For the second learner, old value is better. For the third learner, new value is better. For the fourth learner, older value is better. And for the fifth learner, you can see here, fifth value is better. Now you can see the final population we have for the five individual and their cost, you can see here. And among all, you can see the best learner is fourth one, and we will consider this teacher in the next iteration. Now here the first iteration completed, and the optimum value that we obtained in the first iteration is this one. And now this is the teacher, that value we will use in the next iteration. So in the second iteration, we have the population size here, this one, and cost values you can see here, this one, and this is the teacher value. So in the second iteration, we will start from the main loop. As you know, this in this algorithm, the best learner among all is considered as the teacher. So this is the best solution among all. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.